Hey there everybody, welcome back. This is Ram here, and if you've been watching my channel at all, then you know that I do a bunch of different stuff in Blender. And I've even started streaming some different stuff in Blender. So having a PC that can run Blender well is important to me. And I haven't seen a good PC list for Blender in at least like 7 or 8 months, if not a year or two. But there's been a whole bunch of new PC hardware that's came out fairly recently, so I think that it's time that I make a PC parts list for Blender's Cycle Render Engine. Yes, this is Cycle Render Engine because I think it's better, but here's my pick of PC parts for cycles. Now, to start off here, this is my overall list, and I believe it comes to about $1,120 something dollars, shipping included. The case up here isn't included inside the calculated cost down here. So the total's around $1,123. Now, this isn't like some super high-end machine, and I'll run through each one of these parts more specifically in just a second. But what this is this just is going to be a you're new to Blender, you're starting to get a hang of it, and you want to do a lot more with it. So you're going to build a good desktop computer that'll last you a while. This computer will have a lot of room for expansion in it, and shouldn't break the bank at $1,100. And you might be saying, "Well, that's really expensive." Well, I'll even show you what things you can cut out just to get started and what things you can get a little bit lower. Plus, this price is inflated a little bit just because of some of the GPU stuff that's been going on recently with cryptocurrency mining. So, I think without further ado, let's get into this. So, to start off, our system is going to be an AMD Ryzen 5 processor-based system. The reason that we're doing Ryzen 5 instead of Intel is because the values that they're giving right now, while they aren't the absolute best for gaming, so I wouldn't recommend them if you're going to do professional gaming. Any other situation than that, I would basically recommend an AMD processor. Yes, any other situation than that, because the raw throughput of these chips is just unbelievable for their price. And even at the high end, when you just need the best of the best, unless you're going to move to some of the new, or some of the server chips that Intel has, because you just need that much raw performance, I would even say wait on those until AMD gets Threadripper and Epic out, because those are probably going to be, or, well, we can see from prices and leaked prices, those are way better deals. So let's just get started with this chip. So the reason why I chose this chip is because it's a 6-core chip. Now, even though in single-thread performance Intel is beating AMD one, that's because you have to have good RAM with your chip, and which isn't a factor with Intel, not normally. With AMD, it is a big factor. We'll get into that in a few minutes, though. And two, even though, like I said, single-thread performance, they're definitely better. That's because of their clock speeds, which an Intel will easily turbo up to 4.3 or higher, depending on if you get a K SKU or a higher SKU chip, where here this won't. But you get two more physical cores with this, and an additional four more threads over i7 7700K. So there's really no good reason why you should buy that, and those will even suck more power. I believe that's around like 90 something watts, or this is 65 watts. So those extra threads really make up the ground in something like Blender, because Blender is heavily multi-threaded, at least the more current versions are, which I would recommend you use because they're updated and more efficient. And then also, this technically offers more PCIe lanes, which with cycles is a big deal. Now there's some caveats to that, but this build is sort of worked around that. So next let's get to sort of the spine of our system, which will be the motherboard. Now this motherboard is really nice because I specifically picked it out so that we can have two GPUs inside here. Now we're not going to start off with two GPUs, obviously, because this is sort of a beginning guide, but it has the room for two GPUs and maybe even three, although the third one might be pushing it. So to take a closer look at this thing, it's got four RAM slots. We're only going to start out with two sticks for right now, but it can hold up to four, so that'll be pretty good. It is a good overclocking board, so if you want to get that core speed up for your processor and get some more performance out of your processor down the road, you definitely can. As I said, you've got two GPUs inside there for cycles. That's a really big deal. You may even be able to fit a third one in there, but you can't use these PCIe 1X slots here. And I believe you also can't use the M.2. So if you're going to plan on using those, then you won't be able to use a third GPU. But you can use those, at least most of them, and get away with using two GPUs. These are Gen 3. This is 16X. This is 8X. This is a Gen 2 8X slot. So keep that in mind. It's got lots of 3.0 USB expansion. And if we check here real fast, I believe it also has, okay good, we are on settings. I believe it also has USB 3.1 Gen 2 expansion on it too. Yeah, there we go. So we've got two Gen 2 ports on there. So if you need that, then you've got that as well. So this motherboard really, I think, even though it is a bit more expensive, you get a $15 rebate, which if you use will put it down to $124. I know that's expensive for a motherboard, but this really gives you the amount of expansion that you'd want for using Blender. Specifically, those two GPU slots. That's going to be really important. Now, moving up, we've got our RAM here. Like I said, Ryzen really needs good RAM, so we paid a little bit extra, but not much, on getting RAM that's rated to go up to 3000 megahertz. Now you will have to, I believe it's enable XMP. This isn't a comprehensive guide on RAM overclocking, but do some quick searching. You gotta enable those higher speeds, and you might even need to do a little bit of overclocking. That's okay, this RAM is rated for it. Just go until your PC can't handle those speeds anymore. You're not going to kill anything. I mean, it's not like any crazy overvolting or anything like that. It's really, really simple stuff to get this RAM up to the correct speed, and you want to do that. That's going to add probably about 5 to maybe a max of like 30% performance to this chip. So you're going to want to do that. And this, like I said, this RAM's rated for it. It's 16 gigs. In Blender, I rarely use above like 8 or 9, I've gotten as high as 10 or 11, and that should give you enough room to still run your OS in the background. So, I mean, there you go, you've got that basically covered. And like I said, this is only two sticks, so you can stick in two more sticks and get this up to 32 gigs of RAM pretty easy. Now for the interesting part that probably a lot of you have been waiting for, we have our graphics card. And this, I chose a 1080 because the Bitcoin mining right now has jumped prices of 1070s up so high that they're basically more expensive than 1080s a lot of the places that you look. And if you find a cheap 1080, then yeah, it's going to be, I don't know, this was like $50 to $100 less than the 1070s that I saw. I am on Newegg, and you can find some lower prices other places, but it's just more convenient to show this on Newegg, and Newegg's normally pretty low on its prices. So if you live in the States, go on Newegg, spec it out, then go through and check secondary vendors. excuse me, my voice today. Sheesh. But yeah, I recommend the 1080 because price to performance right now, it is the absolute best. You're going to get some killer performance out of this. And the main thing to look out for when you're doing research for your graphics cards is the amount of VRAM that it has. This has 8 gigs of VRAM on it. I'm running into bottlenecks on mine where I only have 4 gigs of VRAM. And even though I've got two GPUs that both have 4 gigs, that it doesn't scale to 8. So this 8 gigs of VRAM is really going to help you out. Because if you go over that 8 gigs of VRAM, if you have to stay above 8 gigs of VRAM, or the VRAM that you have inside your graphics card, then you're going to have to render on your CPU, which is going to take at least twice, if not, if for this situation, probably like 5 or 6 times as long, if not longer, depending on your scene. So that's why I really recommend 8 gigs, or I recommend a 1080 or a 1070. You can buy a 1060, but if you get a 1060, get the 6 gig edition of it. You want that extra VRAM. If you're worried about SLI only going up to 2, don't use SLI when you're using cycles. I've seen some tests in the past that show SLI actually hurting your cycles performance. It wouldn't surprise me. Just slot them in and power them, and you're good. That's why you have the option of a third GPU, because you don't need SLI to run your GPUs together in cycles. Now, what's going to actually power this beast? So, for the power, we have an 850 watt thermal take 80 plus bronze power supply. Yes, it's only 80 plus bronze, but it's partially modular, and I don't know why it's showing it so small. It's partially modular, so you can make it look pretty inside your case. And thermal take's a good brand. 80 plus bronze is, you know, that's definitely good enough for you. It'll be fine. Your power bill isn't going to be through the roof. And you don't need full modular. You're going to use all those other cables anyways. So it's okay. You can hide it behind in the cable management areas. There are cable management inside this build, so whatever. You can get a lower end power supply if you want, but this is built for expansion so that you can have that third GPU inside there. For if you want to look at the layout real fast, it's got 400 or sorry 840 watts on the 12 volt rail, so that's pretty good. Now you can't pull that many watts just on the 12 volt rail and expect the rest of it to go just fine. But the thing is that it's got a lot of room there for you to work with. And that's the whole point of this build. It's to start you off in a good place and give you room to grow. Now, for the storage device, for the first 5 years of owning my desktop, I just had a 500 gig hard drive. So 1 terabyte, you should be fine. WD Blue, it's got like a 2 year warranty on it. You can get a 3 or 4 year warranty if you want. 4 year warranty right there, $8 or $9, basically. 7200 RPM, 64 meg cache, 6 gigabits per second, for the SATA 6 gig. Yeah. I mean, basic hard drive. And I don't have the case up here, so let's pull that up. The case is going to be a DIY, I can't pronounce this word. Mergage, whatever. Being dyslexic doesn't help sometimes. So this case, one, it looks pretty. It looks very pretty. It fits sort of the black and gray aesthetic that we're going with here. But then also, it gives you a bunch of different room for hard drives. If you want 3 1/4 inch bays, there they are. It has a SD card reader in the front. So extra functionality, USB 2, USB 3, headphones, yada yada yada. Comes with 3 fans. That's pretty good for just starting out with the PC. 3 fans. That's nice. And then, I mean, there's all your cords. Some of them are colored. Spray paint them if you want. I mean, it doesn't really matter. Put tape over them. This is a beginner's Blender PC. Now, I say beginners, but this thing is gonna just crush most of what a beginner would do, and it's pretty good for even a moderate to low to high end, low on the high end side user. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions, leave them down below in the comment section. God bless. See you next time. Bye.